On 24th October this year, First Lady Margaret Kenyatta was named the United Nations in Kenya Person of the Year and honored for her efforts to reduce maternal and infant mortality in the country through her Beyond Zero campaign.
Kenya Person of the Year, runner-up.
Also feted alongside the First Lady was Fanis Lisiagali, the Director of Healthcare Assistance Kenya, for her efforts to eliminate sexual and gender-based violence in Kenya. She was the runners-up United Nations in Kenya Person of the Year.
This has come with a lot of power for me. I have been empowered. It's like I am starting my journey. You know, it has been almost like 40 years, but I'm now starting it afresh.
Hack GBV Helpline 1195, good morning.
Hack GBV Helpline 1195, morning.
The phones won't stop ringing, yet the telecounselors at Healthcare Assistance Kenya don't tire of picking each time. On the other end of the line is a cry for help, a call from a victim of sexual and or gender-based violence. It is their decision to break the silence that gives them a voice.
Na hospitali gani iko karibu na wewe, ma'am? Hospitali ya serikali.
The Rapid Response Center is a call away. Victims of sexual and gender-based violence across the country can dial 1195, a toll-free hotline to access counseling services. They are then directed to a police station, a hospital, or a shelter home.
This is the national GBV service provider's map. This map helps us to refer survivors to various service providers.
We have professional telecounselors who work on 24-hour basis. We have received very many calls since we started this call center in 2007. In a day, we can receive not less than 30 responses. And most of the people who report are women, not so much of men.
Statistics on sexual and gender-based violence are compelling as the silence surrounding it fuels the vice.
Psychological torture dominates, then physical assault, then rape, defilement mostly on children. You'll find Nairobi is actually leading in terms of sexual violence.
Yet many victims remain silent in a society where gender-based violence generates a sense of shame and guilt among the victims rather than among the perpetrators. It is why Fanis Lisiagali chose to empower victims to break the silence. She came to the decision during the 2007-2008 post-election violence.
I interacted a lot with women who explained to me their experiences, how they were raped, how their children were defiled, how their husbands were sodomized.
Today, the 1195 toll-free hotline is a lifeline for many. It is confidential, accessible and anonymous, and this has made it possible to fight cases of GBV. Accessing justice for survivors, however, remains the greatest challenge.
We have cases where women have been sent back home to say you don't have money and therefore you can go back home. In any case, you are the one who started this problem.
Undeterred, Fanis Lisiagali continues to spread the message to women, men and children through the Rapid Response Call Center, supported by the government, USAID, the International Rescue Committee and mobile service providers.
We give them our J cards. It's actually a Jikinge card, a sexual violence Jikinge card with our hotline number on and with very big writings to say, and gender-based violence.
But her cause has not been without personal challenges.
Sometimes when we put on our t-shirts with our helpline on 1195, you find people stopping us to query, oh, so yeah, the people who are attacking us men, you know, women are the ones who usually start. And the conversation just goes on and on, you know, to say, why are you just protecting women and all that? So we have to do a lot of explaining to say, you see, we are also protecting men. It's only that you don't talk about it.
Through it all, her family, she says, has been her support system.
I'm married to a very humble man who also realized that this program was very important. And therefore, he supported me a lot in setting it up. escorting me even at odd hours to make sure that I am safe. My children have been amazing. I have three daughters who have also been very, very supportive.
Fanny's Lisiagali stays the cause, offering help, hope and the chance of a better life to victims of gender-based abuse in the 47 counties.
My message to my fellow Kenyans, especially women, they should break the silence.
The sentiments of a woman whose clarion call continues to be, say a big no to sexual and gender-based violence. Salim Bilu, Citizen Weekend.